Okay, so this video is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to start out, I'm going to show you some issues I had, some problems, and then I'm going to ask for your advice at the end of the video, so be sure you stick around for that. So to start the video off, what you're looking at right now is a flight from a few days ago. Earlier this morning, well, the morning of this flight, rather, we had some pretty thick fog, and when the fog started lifting up, this particular flight took place at about 10:30 a.m., if I remember right, 10:30, 11. After the fog started burning off and lifting, the cloud, it was kind of half fog, half clouds, but it looked like they were lingering pretty low in the area, like really low. I would have guessed around 100, 150 feet off the ground. And so I decided I was going to do some sub-250 gram cloud surfing with a little Dart 250. So I ran out and grabbed some batteries and charged them, and by the time I got in the air, the clouds had lifted too much. As you can see here, I'm at 500 feet right now, and we're still not close to them, so they were definitely higher than they looked. But I think I flew up to around 700 or so before I decided to just go ahead and call it quits. Running with that little tiny 2.4 gigahertz video transmitter, and rather the 5.8 gigahertz video transmitter and 2.4 gigahertz for my radio control, I wasn't sure if I would be able to fly through the thick clouds anyway. Probably not. I didn't really expect to be able to, but I was going to try it and see what happened. I mean, I've tested the autopilot and I'm happy it's going to work, return to home and everything. But anyway, I topped 700 feet here and I decided to go ahead and call it quits. So this was pretty much the end of the flight here. I just kind of looked around a little bit up there and then I just went ahead and put the nose down and came back and landed. I didn't even really fly around long. So what you'll see here is the entire flight uncut. You see I've already cut power. I'm starting to push the nose down and lose the altitude and just head back to home. So as far as the problems, like, I just wanted to include this because, like I said, it was kind of like a failure. I thought I was going to go cloud surfing and I didn't. But just kind of more or less as a filler to make the video longer. But anyway, so the problems that I faced with the Dart 250 you'll see coming up next. And it's not a problem with the airplane itself. The airplane's performing beautifully. I'm really happy with the little airplane. I like it. I like the way it flies and its performance and everything. But the issue that I faced was with the video transmitter. And you'll see that in the next flight coming up here shortly. Now, I posted a picture on the community tab on my channel. And you can go look at that. Just click community or whatever. You can see it. I posted a picture. I made a new rear cover for the Dart, the little rear hatch, whatever, vent cover. I 3D printed a new one with a holder for a Foxeer Pagoda antenna that I had here that had the UFL connector that matched up with the video transmitter, so it all worked out. And I moved that to the back of the airplane, and then that allowed me to put the 3S 1300 LiPos in the front and maintain my center of gravity. And I also put the little micro camera that I wanted before, the Micro Sparrow, and maintain the center of gravity. Now, that did push my all-up weight to about 290 grams, I think, so we're well past the 250 limit now, but it doesn't really matter. It's not a concern for me. But so that was the test flight here that you're looking at, the first flight with that setup. So I'm using the circular polarized antennas now that I've used in the past and got great performance with them. And I expected it to do really well, seeing how good this little transmitter did with the stock linear antenna. But as you can see, I'm less than a half mile out here, and my video is already going grainy and everything, and I decided to test my return to home, and what you see on the screen now is what I was met with. So I actually just had to leave it in return to home and let it fly itself back. And you might have noticed on the way out, the video got pretty grainy a couple of times and was really not what I was expecting to see. That's why I decided to go ahead and check my return to home, make sure it was going to function, because I kind of expected to need it. But I really didn't expect the video to be this bad on the return trip. Now, even, you see, I'm just kind of looking through the static here trying to fly it, because I know return to home is almost overhead now, and I just wanted to kind of lose some altitude and get close and see if I could get the video back. Which you can see it did come back, but I mean, I had to get like right on top of myself here for the video to get cleared up again, and it's still kind of in and out and grainy, and it's just not working the way it should. Now, after I landed, I did. Now, I kind of expected to, at this point before I landed, I expected to find the antenna that had, like, fallen off or came out of the little printed mount that I made, or maybe the mount came unglued off the airplane, or maybe even the cable, the connector came unplugged. You know, I wasn't sure what to expect, but I definitely thought something was wrong. You know, I mean, something's clearly is wrong, but I thought there was going to be a physical problem on the airplane. But as you can see, I went ahead and kind of flew around a little bit and figured out if my video was going to work good enough to land or not, and I got it on the ground. And so, like I said, expecting to find those problems, I went over everything and I couldn't find anything wrong. So I basically just unplugged everything, replugged it, checked the antennas on the receiver because I had just swapped those back to the circular antennas, and everything looked fine. So I decided to try again, just maybe something was loose or whatever, and just going over everything, I might have fixed it. But you can see here I launched and put it into return to home, and immediately the video started going to crap again. Kind of static in and out and grainy, and it's something's not right. So I decided to just go ahead and land it and call it quits. And as you can see here, as I circled around a little bit trying to set up for my landing, it was actually pretty sketchy trying to get it back on the ground through the static. You can see I start losing video here, but I kind of knew about where I was at, so I just flew through it and to go line up with the runway, and once again I lost video completely there for a minute, and just kind of having to fly through the static to get it back on the ground. But so that's the problem I have right now. I haven't even fixed it yet. Like I said, I did pull it apart, and I even took the little antenna completely apart. So we'll switch over to my webcam now so I can show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so now we're using this camera. I can show you, like I said, this is the little antenna. As you can see, I physically took it apart. Now, I did break it when I took it apart. I don't recommend trying to get these apart because they're glued together, and it's kind of a destructive process. But the little top board was still soldered here. I broke this board off of the antenna trying to get it apart, trying to break the case apart. But I expected to kind of find like the coax is broken here or something, because everything outside the antenna looked fine. But I don't think there was a problem with this antenna, at least until I took it apart. You know, it's broken now, but I don't think there was anything wrong with this antenna. Now I do have another black one here. That's what they look like when they're still assembled. But I don't think the issue was with the antenna. I think it was fine. That's just a little top cover came off of it. So I don't think the problem was with the antenna. I'm not sure what to think other than maybe the video transmitter, the amplifier maybe went out. Now it does still heat up. It runs hot like it should, like you would expect for a video transmitter. And that particular one, like I said, is the Runcam TX200. It's a tiny little 200 milliwatt transmitter, and it does run rather hot. And it does still heat up, you know, pretty hot on the ground. Like I think it's still outputting power. So I'm not really sure what to expect. So my options to fix it. Now, I have this little transmitter over here on this little backpack that I had made that I flew on the Banzai FPV wing quite a while back. This is a little AKK Tech 200 milliwatt little micro transmitter, and it's very similar to the one that I have on the Dart 250 right now, the Runcam one. It even uses the same RF chips and everything. I looked them over close. I could swap that one out. I kind of want to leave it on that little backpack. It's a nice little backpack I made with a little Runcam Nano, and it just has Velcro and I just stick it down. Now the only thing I've used it on was the little Banzai wing, but it's a pretty handy little unit. I like it. I really don't want to take it apart. So my options are to maybe take that apart anyway and put that transmitter in the Dart 250, or I have this AKK Tech X2 Ultimate that has an SMA connector, and I've been wanting to try this little antenna anyway. Little Speedy V antenna that they sent me personalized with my name, says Pirate on it. Now the AKK X2 Ultimate, if you're not familiar with it, it's a fine little transmitter. I forgot what the power levels are, but you can adjust it right up to 1.2 watts if I remember right. I think it's definitely going to be overkill for the Dart 250. Now it's going to weigh a little bit more without the cable and the antenna connector and everything. I think they said it weighs around 6 or 7 grams. But the SMA connector and stuff, it has a lot of brass components on there. It probably weighs more than the transmitter. So it's not super lightweight and it's not really small. But like I said, the sub 250 gram thing is out the window anyway, running my bigger batteries. And I'm not concerned about it. It actually flew fine. It might have even flew a little bit better. It felt like it was pretty smooth. And with added power, the 1300 does output a little bit more power. I'm using the, I don't have one there. They're all over there somewhere. I don't have one within reach, rather. But they're Nanotechs, I think, 1300 3S. And they put more power out than those little 3S 800s that I was using. I have the 800 sitting here on my desk. It's just 20 to 30C, probably 20C 800 3S that I was using before. But the 1300 does put out a little bit more amps when the motor wants it. So it actually climbed out better. It launched better is what I was trying to get at. So I'll go ahead and leave a poll in the community tab. So be sure and go and click on that if you want to voice your opinion. Should I salvage the little Banzai's FPV backpack deal and try this 200 milliwatt AKK tech transmitter? Or should I just put the X2 Ultimate in it and see how far we can fly on 2.4 gigahertz RC control? And I'm actually considering, if that becomes an issue, if that becomes my limiter, if I still have enough battery to outfly the 2.4 gigahertz, I do have a spare R9MM 900 megahertz free sky receiver. I can swap that out and kind of make a little medium range, tiny little dart. That's kind of what I'm leaning to at the moment. Put the X2 Ultimate in it and fly it with the 2.4, and then swap that 2.4 out if I need to. And that'll give me a chance to really push that for range anyway, the Fly Sky system, which I do need to start my review on that soon, so keep an eye out. They will be coming up. But anyway, I've rambled on long enough. Go voice your opinion. Vote if you want to, whatever. Maybe just even leave a comment if you have any other suggestions. But yeah, like I said, I decided to do it like this, get some input on what you want to see, because it's weather is less than favorable coming up here. I'm not in any rush. I have time. So thank you for watching the video. Thank you for all the likes, comments, subscribes, even the dislikes. I like those too. And of course, Patreon supporters. So we will see you all in the next video.